Hey, hi. When we have linear regression, polynomial linear regression, why do we need decision tree regression? How are splits made when your output variable is continuous, that is in case of decision trees? So in this video, I'll go over a simple data set explaining how decision tree regressor works. I hope you all like it. If you do like the content that I post on my channel, please do subscribe to my channel. That motivates me to make more such videos. Thank you. Let's start by importing the necessary modules. This example is to demonstrate how a decision tree regressor works. So I have a sample data in a file called a sample_data_1.csv. I'll import that file or import that data into a data frame called df_1. This is how my data frame looks like. The idea that you have to keep in mind for this data frame is you have two columns, pass_fail and score, where score is my target variable, which is continuous in nature. Pass_fail is my feature, which is discrete in nature, which will have values 0 and 1. For scores less than 40, the pass_fail value is 0. For score greater than equal to 40, my pass_fail value is equal to 1. Let's now visualize a scatter plot between both x and y to see how the data looks like. So this is how my data looks like. I have two discrete values in my x direction, which is 1 and 0, and my output values are continuous in nature. If I fit a normal linear regression for this, I won't get the best fit line, and there would be some questions raised on the predictions that I make from this best fit line using linear regression. So what do? I go in for something called as decision tree regressor. I create an instance of decision tree regressor and save it into a variable dt_reg. I split my x and y values from my data frame and fit those values into dt_reg. Once I have done that, now I'll be plotting my decision tree boundaries along with the splits with the scatter plot of x and y. So this is how my decision tree regressor output along with the scatter plot looks like. So the way a decision tree regressor works is when you have discrete variables in x, it tries to find a point between the two discrete variables, that is 0 and 1. So it chooses a value of 0.5. Any value less than 0.5, for it to make a prediction, it uses the average values of points assigned to that discrete value. What I mean to say by that is, I had 39 values from 1 to 39, which had values or which had x values to be equal to 0. So I collect all the values and I take the average of those values, and that turns out to be 20. I do the same exercise, or decision tree does the same exercise, for values for which pass_fail is assigned to 1, collects all the values and takes the average of those values, and that value turns out to be 70. Now if I have to make a prediction for 1 and 0, let's start by making a prediction for 1. For a value, input value of 1, that is for an input pass_fail value of 1, my output is 70, which is average of all the values that I trained for which had pass_fail value to be 1. Similarly, when I do this exercise for 0, I will get a value of 20. So if this idea is clear, I have chosen x to be discrete and y to be continuous. Something similar happens when you have x as continuous and y as continuous as well. So let's load the next data file into a data frame called df_2, and let's visualize how the data looks like. You have continuous variables in input and continuous variables in output. When I plot a scatter plot of both x and y, that is in and out, this is how it looks. So I can use a simple polynomial regression with some higher degree order to fit the data that I have. But rather than doing that, if I go the decision tree route, first, I'll split the x and y values from my df, then fit those values into a decision tree regression. Once I've done that, I'll now try to plot the scatter plot of x and y along with the decision tree boundaries. So this is how the values, or this is how the output turns up. These red points are my scatter plot points, and this is the point wherein the split is made. So if I consider these two points, that is this point and this point, a point or a value between the two points is chosen for a split. Any value less than that is assigned the average value so far. Any values greater than that is assigned a value here. So this is how simple my decision tree regressor works for a continuous feature along with a continuous target variable. If I make a prediction in similar grounds, I'll get corresponding values of the split or where the point lies post the split is made. So this was my attempt at explaining how a decision tree regressor works and how splits are made based on minimum mean square error. If you do have any questions with what we have covered in this video, then feel free to ask in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer those. If you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then the easiest way is to simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also it's a huge help to share these videos with anyone whom you think would find them useful. Please consider clicking the subscribe button to be notified for future videos. And thank you so much for watching.